AI-generated art is becoming more and more popular, and it's quite logical that we are seeing plenty of tools that allow us to generate artwork from text inputs in a matter of seconds. Basically, it can be said that everyone can find the tool that suits them best, and for me, it is a tool called DreamStudio. DreamStudio is an online tool based on stable diffusion text-to-image AI technology, which is similar to DALL-E 2 and works on any PC, Mac or smartphone. Unlike DALL-E 2, DreamStudio is much cheaper and more convenient to use. And in this video, I want to show you how to use this incredible tool and how to force it to generate fantastic art. To use DreamStudio, you need to open an account and then you get 200 free credits to test the possibilities of this art generator. And don't worry, the link to this tool can be found in the description of this video. When you open the DreamStudio, you are welcomed with a clear interface with few sliders on the right side. But first, let's take a look at the left side, where you can find a menu. We've got here a dream option, which I will talk about later. Then we have a history, which means all your creations would be stored here. The next is a prompt guide, an introduction to the basics of prompt creation. And the last two options in the menu are social information and a short FAQ section. This was just a short overview of the menu, but let's go to the more interesting part of this video. Let's go back to the Dream interface, which is a screen that has the most of the features you need for artwork generation. On the right side of the screen, you can see different sliders with a few features that affect the quality of the generated artwork as well as the price of it. As I already mentioned, if you open an account, you get free credits to test the quality of the AI art generator. However, after you spend all the credits, you need to buy more credits to continue using DreamStudio. However, the pricing model is reasonable and much cheaper than the main competitor, DALL-E 2, which provides similar results if I'm talking about the quality of designs. So, with the basic settings, you can generate up to 9 images from one prompt for a price of 1 cent. Which is a fantastic news for everyone who cannot use the stable diffusion code on the computer because of the graphics card limitation. Let's go back to the different sliders and talk about how important some of them are for the resulting design. The first two sliders are the width and height of the image. While you can use them to get a maximum pixel image size of 1024 by 1024 pixels, as you can see here in the tab, it will cost you more credits. I'm using the default, cheapest image size because I know how to upscale images with free AI tools without losing quality. And of course, I will do a video about this in the future. The next useful slider in DreamStudio is for the CFG scale feature. With the CFG scale, you can force the AI to follow exactly your prompt. However, you don't want to set the slider to the maximum value because you will get too many repetitive results. But you don't want to set it to the minimum value either because this gives the AI too much creative freedom and it will generate an image that is not following the prompt at all. I would recommend to play with it and find a sweet spot for your designs. Using this feature does not cost you any credits. And finally, I want to talk about the most important feature when it comes to the artwork quality. The step slider is saying AI how many steps to spend generating your image. If you want to get a more detailed and complex image, then you should use the most step possible. However, this would cost you more credits. In my opinion, 50 steps should be okay for most generations. The next slider is giving you the opportunity to generate more images from one prompt. The next feature is the sampler, and I would recommend leaving it as it is. This is too much advanced feature, and the default KLMS sampler is working great, and even the model of generation should be left on the default value. See, this is the last feature, and it simply means that every image you generate is getting a unique seed and can be used to fine-tune for the prompts you are using. DreamStudio is quite easy to use tool, and while you know the basic on how to use it, let's give it a chance to generate some images. The magic of using any AR art generator is to find the right prompt. This can be quite difficult to learn, especially for beginners. But for such people, or for everyone who needs to find a style or get inspiration, I introduce you to Lexica. Lexica is a free tool that is searching a database of stable diffusion prompts used by other creators. And it is quite easy to use. Just put any keywords in the search bar and get related results. If you like any image from the search, just click on it and copy the prompt. Let's copy this prompt and paste it to the DreamStudio. It is incredible how great the results DreamStudio is giving me, and all this for the cost of 1 cent. I think DreamStudio is a fantastic, user-friendly tool that will find many happy users. If you want to try it for free, you can use the link in the description of this video, and I'm not affiliate on this tool, so this is just an honest recommendation. I hope this video was helpful for you, and if you have any question about AI-generated art on print-on-demand, use the comment section and I will try to reply.